We've just been walking along this bank, and as you can hear by the wind, it's pretty wind blown. Not our target species today, but did manage to pick up a small redfin on a vibe. These are apparently pretty tasty to eat, so we have never tried one of these before, so we're actually going to take it for the table today and just give it a bit of a test and see how it comes up. But so far, since we've been walking along this bank, we've had more follows than the other banks, and have picked up a couple of these today just on small vibration lures, so it sort of makes the middle of the day a little bit more interesting. Here it is, nice little rainbow trout that Cherie just pulled in on a 2D switch plate in gold. Just fishing these windblown banks again, so fish are definitely moving along this edge. Picked up this little fish anyway, had these hollows right up to the bank. I'm just going to get this one back in the water, he's ready to go. And away they go again to fight another day. Type of gear that we use out here today, as you can tell, it's pretty cold and pretty blowy, so we're dressed up to the nines. But you know, I've got about three or four layers of clothing on, so that's just a long sleeve shirt and then a fleece and then a shell jacket, so that helps keep the wind and the rain away from my body. And when we're walking the banks like this, you want to be nice and comfortable. And with that kind of layer system on your clothing, it means that the air will get out. You're not going to get too hot throughout the day, even though it's pretty cold outside. Today we're just using, you know, just sort of 7'2" lightweight spin sticks. The reels that I use are Dio Alluvius at the moment. They seem to be a pretty good reel. And 2G Lumis rods. This one's an IMX SR762. This one here is the drop shot series. It's ideal for plastics, but today I'm actually using it for small hard body work. And this one here, we're using a lightweight crankbait. Both of the outfits are spooled up with fire line. So this one here is running 6 pound in the crystal, and this one here is 4 pound in the new pink color. So I'm just giving that a bit of a try. The leaders that we use for walking the banks are about 8 pound. So I use a copolymer, which is a blend of a nylon and a fluorocarbon. That seems to be quite good. And 8 pound, just because you don't know what you're going to come across. Well, most of our fish are probably 1.5 to 2 pound kind of stuff, but you can come across some 5 and 6 pound. So we'll just go up, you know, up the leader a little bit just in case. That's really about it. Okay. The kind of lures that I'm using today is just a lipless crankbait. At the moment I'm using gold, but we find that bronze and silver work really well in this kind of condition as well. And on this sort of spin stick here, I've just got a small medium diver. This one's an eco gear in the rainbow trout pattern. But we've got heaps of gear with us, and we do tend to bring an excessive amount. As you'll see, there's a few tackle boxes over this way, just full of divers and plastics and more vibrations. You just don't know what the fish are going to be chomping on the day, so it helps if you can carry it all in a sort of a 25 litre day pack, a little bit of water and some supplies, and the rest of it's tackle. So happy bank walking. So today we're back just walking the banks again, just fishing in pairs. So Cherie's actually working ahead of me in this particular case. We're probably about maybe about 20 or 30 metres apart, and I'm just making about 5 casts in one particular location before we move on. And I'm using a vibration kind of lure, small blade, and Cherie's using the same lure but in a different colour. We have found that they do go quite well in this cold weather, so we're just trying to work out the colour pattern that's going to switch the fish on today. You notice that Cherie likes to stand back from the bank a little bit. Enables her to work that lure right up to the edge, and you will get trout that'll follow your lure right in, and then they'll slam you right, you know, about a foot away from the edge of the bank. So it also helps with the vibration just walking along. Trout are fairly sensitive sort of fish, so any noises that you can minimise when you're walking these banks will help you have a bit more of a productive day. Cheers. when you're fishing these windblown banks, it pays to keep your eyes peeled. I've just found this little minnow washed up against the bank here. We know that the fish feed on these in this particular location. So we're trying to mirror our lure size and our coloration to this kind of bait fish. So I'm using a clear vibe and Cherie's using a grey vibe at the moment, so we'll see what happens. Alright, it's time to change locations. We've worked this bank here for about an hour. I've had a few follows right up to the edges down here, but we can't get the fish to switch on. We've noticed that the wind is blowing all the way down that back end of the lake, so it's time to pack up and head down that way so we can't find the fish feeding against those wind-blown edges down there. So we'll be back filming shortly, hopefully with some fish. Okay, we've arrived at our third destination for today. After number two, looked like it wasn't going to be too productive. The windblown banks that we want to hit are along this edge down here, so you can see from this elevated position the wind just pushing onto these banks and having a little bit of wave action down there. What we're hoping for is that the surface food, which has been blown into the water, is actually washing up on this bank, and that the trout are going to be patrolling along this edge over here. So the kind of lures that we're going to use again today on this session is I've got a small vibe in a natural kind of colour with a darker kind of background to silhouette against the darker sky. Now we're finding that the natural colours really aren't producing for us, but I'm still going to persevere with it because I know that it'll work. And the other one that we're going to try is a really bright lure, something that's totally different to what we normally fish today. But we've had a few follows, and we're going to use this brighter colour to try and fire the trout up and get them to hit. There it is, Cherie's got a nice little rainbow trout again on a gold TT switchblade. So really is proven that that's the lure of the day. In it comes. We'll get this one off and get it back in the water really quick. They're pretty little fish in the water. Their spots light up and that pink stripe just sets them right off. Certainly knows where home is. Just bring him in, use a set of pliers, get those hooks out of him, and we can head back home. Just as easy as that. In a really nice condition, they're really healthy at this time of year. They're feeding up for their spawning run into the rivers. They just cruise along the banks and just gorge themselves. Get this one up here nice and quick, get him out of the mud. This one's actually a brown trout. So you notice the difference that there's no pink stripe along this fish. But same sort of lure. We're going to need to take care of this one really quickly, get him back in the water. He's only a real small fish, but still nice and healthy. Just no pink stripe. But you've got the brown and the red dots along his back there. You don't catch as many of these kind of fish in this dam here, but you do get the occasional one. So this time of year, these ones are really spawning up. So they should, most of them should be in the rivers by now, or they'll be there very shortly. So we'll unhook this one and get him back in. That brings the end to another successful session at Lake Oberon this weekend. So luckily we just persisted with trying different options, and this afternoon we came across a real patch of fish. So it just proved that just got to keep moving around and finding where those fish are, and just go back to that lure that was really successful today, and that's a TT switchblade in the gold colour in the 1/8. We tried heaps of lures today, but we had to keep coming back to this one because it was just producing the fish for us. And that's probably the best thing that I can recommend, is that take your tackle box along with it, just keep changing your rules, and you'll find the pattern that the fish want to chew on, and from there just keep working with it. So we've had a great weekend again. Cheers.